people have learned that in England, that people with Parkinson's, in the sense that they end up with tremors, physical tremors, who rode the train, derived benefit from the mechanical vibration of the train that the person was experiencing that reduced their symptoms to the point where they were able to do things more normally. Faculty at Stanford had developed the pulse sequences and the duration of vibration to the people's fingers, and basically what they're doing is taking a coin cell motor that makes a phone like this vibrate, that gets placed inside a glove and located in a way so that the motor is touching the person's fingertip in an attempt to try to mimic that vibratory treatment that the train somehow provided.
The fingertips are kind of this very easy, accessible pathway to those sensory motor areas in the brain. It can try to straighten out or unscramble or reset some of those sensory motor patterns that are kind of asynchronously firing. Here at the university, we have our Parkinson's exercise program, and within that, we have some members talking about some of these vibrotactile gloves.
They were trying to build their own versions at home, but they also wanted something more mobile because a lot of it was stationary.
We went in with the patients in mind, in a sense. We said, how can we make this comfortable to use? How can this be user-friendly? We went and spoke to the patients, read the papers, and kind of made a plan where we began to tackle the actual process, built the actual first prototype.
I was involved in making the electrical circuits that run the motors, and I was also involved in designing the whole device.
These are all battery-powered gloves. Part A in our study is to increase the accessibility for something like this. These are commercially available devices. You can buy these, but they cost upwards of $500, $800, over $1,000. Well, with funding, we can very easily make 20 to 30 pairs of these and distribute them to our community members here in the Chippewa Valley. In discussions with Dr. Fugoso, he's over at Mayo, and for this to have direct translation into his practice to offer another technology that currently doesn't get offered just increases the potential treatment options for people in our community.
The potential applications and the potential benefit to people suffering with this disease, knowing as I do somebody that's had that struggle, that's the most compelling part for me.
To have an impact is kind of like amazing, I guess, because that was one of the things that I came in choosing this major. I was like, if I could just help one person, that'd be great. And so to have the chance now to possibly help the people in the Parkinson's program to have access to these gloves, that would just be amazing.